Hello everyone in Medical Scribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. In the previous video, we talked about the deep fascia subtypes, or the deep fascia classification. And we explained the forms that the deep fascia can be present with. All that were in the previous video. But today, we will explain the deep fascia functions. After we know that the deep fascia will be exist in most regions of the body, and it will take many forms, in which every form will have many functions, so if you collect the functions of all forms and all subtypes of deep fascia, it will be about 7 main functions. The first function is that the deep fascia will cover and surround many structures and most body regions, including the bones, the muscles, the nerves, and the blood vessels, in which it will hold them in place. The second function is about the intermuscular septa. That if we remember, we said it will form the facial compartments, which are very important. Because if an infection or a tumor occur in one compartment, this intermuscular septa will limit the ability of the infection or the tumor to affect the other compartments. The third function we have is that the aponeurosis, which is one subtype of the deep fascia. This aponeurosis will give an origin or insertion to other muscles. While the fourth function is about the retinacula, which are one form of the deep fascia. This retinaculum will hold the tendon of muscle in place during joint movements and will prevent them from bowing. The fifth function of the deep fascia is that the deep fascia can respond to the sensory input. That means it can respond to different stimuli in which it will either contract or relax, and it can change, added, or reduce its composition through the process of facial remodeling. Well, the sixth function of deep fascia will require a simple introduction to understand it clearly. We know that the blood that pumped from the heart will move in arteries firstly. Then it will return to the heart through the veins. So in the arteries, the blood will move by the force of the heart pump. While in the veins, the process is different, because the blood will return to the heart by the action of the valves, which make the blood to move in one direction, the muscle, that when contract, will squeeze the vein so the blood will be pushed up, and from above the heart level, the gravity will also play an important role in returning the blood to the heart. So these structures that help the blood returning to the heart, which are the valves and the muscles, will be called the musculovenous pump. Alright? Good. So the deep fascia, in addition to the muscles and the valves, will also help the veins in a specific mechanism to return the blood to the heart. And the last function we have in this video about the deep fascia is that the myofibroblasts, which exist in the deep fascia, may play a role in wound healing. So these are almost important functions of the deep fascia. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.